Welcome back. We are now on the next stop in the momentum and impulse part. A very interesting one and easy to comprehend, which is about collisions. So when two objects now collide, we have got two types of collisions. One they say is real, which is your elastic. All real collisions are inelastic. Then all imaginary collisions are elastic, meaning that what is an elastic collision and what is a inelastic collision. Elastic, if we have learned, if you remember Boyle's law in grade 11, we are saying particles of an ideal gas collide elastically, meaning that when they collide there is no loss of energy. In both collisions, momentum is conserved. Momentum is conserved. We'll talk about this. Momentum is conserved. Is conserved. Meaning that now, conservation, meaning that momentum, the final momentum, and equals to the initial momentum. Or the initial cost to final. So that is when you say momentum is conserved. But in the elastic collision, kinetic energy is also conserved. And here, kinetic energy is not conserved. Very important. That's what differentiates the two collisions. Meaning that now, if you were to differentiate between elastic and inelastic, we are not going to compare momentum, but we have to compare what? The energy conservation. Therefore, if energy is conserved, that collision was elastic. If energy is not conserved, then that collision is inelastic. Energy is conserved in that the total kinetic energy before equals to the total kinetic energy after collision. In this case, the total kinetic energy before is not the same as the total kinetic energy after. Very important is this one. I mean that if you are to conclude or to prove whether collision is elastic or inelastic, you use kinetic energy. Look at the two objects before collision, find the total kinetic energy, and then compare. You just work out that one, the total kinetic energy of the two before collision. If they are separate, then no problem. You find the initial kinetic energy of A plus initial kinetic energy of B. If the two objects were separate, and then you find the answer in joules. Secondly, you move on and say the total kinetic energy after. If they are still separate, no problem. Kinetic energy of this one final of A plus kinetic energy final of B. Therefore, you find that one in joules, you compare the two values. If they are equal, meaning that the collision is elastic. If they are not equal, the collision is inelastic. Then that's how you prove whether collision is elastic or inelastic. So that's how you deal with this section. Now, before we go to real questions, then let's talk about conservation of momentum now, because we entertain the conservation of momentum here. Conservation of momentum. Of momentum. Momentum, momentum, momentum. When you say momentum is conserved, we mean that we said the total momentum before initial should be the same as the total momentum after. That's why we say momentum is conserved, mean that conservation, that's how it happens. Now, this happens only in a certain condition. The system must be isolated. So this one is only possible in an isolated system. Possible in a closed or isolated system. Isolated system. Now, what is an isolated system in this case? It's very easy. If you go to your definitions in grade 11 as well, you learned about it. It happens even in grade 10 when we're dealing with mechanical energy. Now, this isolated system is always a system whereby the resultant force, in this case, the resultant force F net equals to zero, or the external forces, you can just say, or external, in this case, force, the net external force, net external force is zero. Then we say the system is isolated or is closed in this case. So meaning that when you define the principle, because now there will be the principle of conservation of linear momentum. Principle of conservation of linear momentum. And that in our case now we deal with only linear. It can be either like along the same line in this case, horizontal or vertical. So we don't have any other in this case. So momentum can be horizontally or vertically, or maybe sometimes in an incline, no problem. But we talk about the linear. So fine. How defining this one now, because you say momentum only conserved in an isolated system. That's why we'll say now, in an isolated system, or this in an isolated system, we have to mention that one, the weight total should be there. No total, meaning that the sigma is out. So the total linear momentum is conserved. Very simple definition. Or the total linear momentum of an isolated system is conserved. So it depends there, but the very key words then now becomes the word isolated system, and the total momentum is conserved. That's the case. If you forget the linear, it's fine, but if you want to be explicit, then you have to say every key weight. So that is the case. I mean that now when you deal with this one, we always encourage learners to say the first step when we are dealing with conservation of linear momentum, you are going to tell us that sigma pi equals to sigma pf. That's the case. Now there are three scenarios in our momentum here. Let me just share with you these three scenarios where you'll find questions. And the three scenarios that are very easy to comprehend scenarios. First scenario is where now the objects were separate before collision, and separate mean that after you've written your sigma pi equals to sigma pf, which will give you 1 mark for making the principle, interpret the principle, then we will now have the two objects are separate before mv plus mv equals to mv plus mv. Now, if you want to put flesh to this one to say, because now they're all mvs, which one is which? Say m1 v1i equals to m2 v2i, that is the initial part, and then m1 v1f and m2 v2f. Very perfect. Then you have interpreted that. And then we come to the next one to say, the second scenario is where now we have got they are separate before collision, and then after collision they are combined. Now this is the case. So now to separate the two again, we'll have m1 v1i plus m2 v2i in this case, and m1 plus m2, and then vf. I mean that after collision they are combined. So the bullet stuck into the block and then they move together. So that will be the case. And then The last one is where now they were combined before. M1 plus M2, they were combined one unit, and then after collision they are separate, MV. Therefore, this is the initial, and then after collision we'll have M1 V1F and M2 V2F. These are the three most important scenarios. We'll expand on this. All questions will cater this, so to make it simple, but otherwise you can use the first one for all the scenarios, as long as you know that if you are coming to the second one, V1F and V2F is the same. If you come to this one, therefore it means that now V1I and V2I is the same, so you can apply this one. But anyway, to make it simple, you can interpret it in this case. I hope we understand each other so far, and good luck. We'll be now moving to the problem solving now. But on the basis of what we have learned now, we learned about momentum, we learned about the change in momentum, we learned about the impulse and Newton's second law, we learned about also the collisions, we learned about the isolated system, we learned about the conservation of linear momentum. So therefore, after this, you will know that when you are defining Newton's second law, you can define in terms of acceleration, like F net equals to ma, and then, or define it in terms of momentum, where now you will say F net equals to delta P over delta T. That is the rate of change in momentum. So you have got these two options for Newton's second law. It's either you define in terms of acceleration or in terms of momentum. So we'll expand on this when questions comes. So otherwise, thanks for now, and sure.